And then once you break open, ooh, come on, the caramel just oozes out. Very, very good. Channel Turkish Delight. Hope you're all doing super well and delightful. Sorry I've been a little bit MIA. I've been traveling yet again, visiting my family in Kansas City, Missouri. So shout out to anyone who lives there because I was there and it's like my second hometown. So yeah. Today's video is just gonna be a little more or less winter favorite since winter is almost over. Can you guys believe it? To be honest, we haven't really had much of a winter here. Not complaining, of course, but I figured might as well, and yeah. So there's just a little favorites of makeup, beauty, miscellaneous things. So let's get started. So the first item, which a lot of people, it's not really a new item, but it's actually not a new item at all, but it is the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Palette. This I've used pretty much every single day whilst on my trip, and it's been a beauty. A lot of people use, of course, this is the product for those who don't know what it is. It's three illuminating powders, and there's like a very light one, a kind of not a really an ashy color. Whoop, I'm blinding you guys, I'm sorry about that. Not per se like an ashy kind, but brown, not even a brown. I'm not very, I don't know how to describe colors that well, which is funny since I studied design, but it's just one of my things I just lack. Anyway, but you can pretty much see the colors here, so I can semi-zoom in. I'm not sure if that's zooming or not, but focusing or not. Wow. Okay. And then like a little bronzy shade. They are called Dim Light, Incandescent Light, and Radiant Light. So yeah, a lot of people use this palette right now to highlight, and I haven't really used it for, whoa, that was close. I'm gonna drag my nail right through the powders. A lot of people have been using this palette for highlighting, and I don't use it for that. I use it, I kind of blend all the colors together and swoosh it all over my face, just a very light buff after my foundation. Generally, if I'm wearing the NARS Sheer Glow, I won't, because that one's already kind of like a very sheer, it kind of lightens, but not so much. I don't know, because it has that sheeriness to it, like the sheer glow, hence the name NARS Sheer Glow Foundation. I tend to just not use this powder with it, but other foundations that just have a regular, normal semi-matte finish to them, I add this and it just kind of brightens up and gives a nice glow, very natural glow to the face. Today I'm not using this powder. Not sure why. I used the Body Shop, the Fresh Nude Foundation, on my face today. Not sure why I didn't use this. It just, I don't know. I skipped it through my process. I was just not feeling it. But yeah, this is absolute love. I do realize that they've increased the price on this at Sephora. Not sure why, and I'm kind of disappointed for that because of the people who want to repurchase it or have yet to purchase it. That's just not cool. So I think they've increased the price by about $4. Could be completely off or it could be spot on. No idea. So yeah, that is that. The next product I'm going to be talking about, another go-to item that I have been using, well, I have used on my trip. It's the Zoeva Naturally Yours palette. I pretty much reach this also again every single day. Just a very, very nice palette. It has a lot of like nudes with some shimmers in them. It is absolutely beautiful and quite on the cheaper, I think, side. I believe I purchased it for $21, $21.50 Canadian, I believe so. it's a very nice palette. Like, you can pretty much use this palette every single day. It's very, like, you can use it at night, you can use it in the daytime. It's versatile and it's very compact and slim. And the pigmentation is absolutely incredible. Like, I swear by this. This is amazing. So if you're just looking for a very, like, not specifically nudes, but like neutral colors, this palette is totally worth it. I know Zoeva like has the other palettes, the Cocoa Blend, the Rose Golden, which I also love. And I took the Cocoa Blend also with me on my trip, but I found myself reaching for this one a lot more. And I've been using this one, not just generally through my trip, as with the powder, I've been using it pretty much all winter. So yeah. So it's a very nice palette, very compact, very sleek packaging, and very, very worth it. The next products. Technically products, because there's two. I found on Sephora that they had a little duo. It wasn't really a duo, but it was sort of like a duo. It was the Urban Decay Perversion Mascara. Why did they come up with these interesting names? And it had a little deluxe sample of the Subversion primer with it. So I said, it's the same price as just the mascara, might as well try the primer with it. And I got it in the mail and it is absolutely incredible. Like, I loved, I purchased this one because I got a little deluxe sample of it and I really liked it. So I decided to purchase the big one, which is the full size, say right here. And, well, like I said, this little guy came with it. So I was like in love with this. And then when this came along, I like loved them both. This primer gets your lashes like so perfect, is not even funny. Like, it gets them so naturally volumized, like looking naturally volumized, naturally long, with a nice curl to them. And when you use an eyelash curler before, like, it holds the curl a lot. Like, it's beautiful. It is a not a plastic wand. Mascara has the little actual brushes for the bristles, and I don't know, it's just a beautiful mascara. The packaging is very bulky and I was kind of scared by that at first, but I went along with it and just absolutely in love. And I seriously think I'm going to be purchasing this. If you know if there's a better eyelash primer, do let me know in the comments below, because I'd love to see what your thoughts are on eyelash primers these days. I do know that it is not something that is talked about. I don't hear it talked about in a lot of videos or in blogs. So yeah, I'd like to see what your thoughts, or if you've tried this and there's something better, then do let me know. So yeah, I don't have this on my lashes today. I used the NARS Audacious mascara. Not so much a fan. I have like a little tiny deluxe sample also, but I don't know, just not feeling that mascara. This one? Yes, I totally am. So the next item is, and this one is pretty much because of Kathleen Lights. I'm not sure which video she had it in, but it was in one of her videos. She's wearing it. I think she put it in a favorites video, and this was like a few months back. July, June, May? I don't know. I honestly have no idea. But this is also something that I have been wearing a lot. It is the MAC Huggable Lip Color in Soft Talkin. And this is the color I have on my lips today. It's very soft, very smooth, it's creamy. It has a beautiful, beautiful scent to it. It's like vanilla, and I love that. It's a very soft vanilla scent. Yeah, but it has almost as if like it has like a lip gloss sheen to it when you put it on the lips, but it doesn't feel like it's a lip gloss because it just hugs the lips so well that it's just like you're wearing, I don't know. I do believe that they've stopped making this color though, which I am so mad. This was honestly my first, no, To be fair, it was my second MAC purchase, and I loved it so much that my mom loved it so much when she saw that I was wearing it. I went out and got a few, and I think I had to purchase them from like, I got this from one location, and it was crazy. Like, I got it shipped from one city to Kansas City, and it was not even located in Kansas City or anywhere near Kansas City for me to get it. And it was not online. I know they did come out because I've kind of been like watching it online. There have been like a lot of different and newer colors that have been added, but none of them is like this beautiful pink. Like, it's like a just heavenly soft baby pink. Like, look at that. Just I don't know if you're gonna be able to see this, but it's so sheer, so smooth. It's like, it's incredible. So yeah, I have been absolutely loving this all winter long. And it's very soft, it feels moisturizing on the lips. Yeah, very moisturizing and pretty, but expensive. But what can you do? You know, what can you do? The next item is not really a makeup item, however, more or less, it's still beauty skincare-ish related. It is the Bath and Body Works, and trust me, I don't even go to Bath and Body Works anymore. I stopped in because my aunt was grabbing something, and at the little counter where they have all the little hand sanitizers, I smelled this little guy and I had to get him. It is the Copacabana Coconut Antibacterial Hand Gel, and it is coconut in a little bottle. It is absolutely, the scent is incredible. I have no idea if it really does anything else, but I bought it pretty much for the scent. So I have been loving this, but I do not really care much for the new packaging. I just don't. The next item is an item for those who wear contact lenses like me. And I have been having the hardest time finding contact lens solution that works well with my contacts. And trust me, like, everyone's different with how their eyes are, whether they're dry or like they produce a good amount of like tears, et cetera, et cetera, and just how sensitive your eyes are. My eyes are really sensitive to pretty much everything. And this solution, I've tried, like, my doctor recommended the clear care solution with, like, I think it's like the hydrogen peroxide and it turns to water in a weird, like, contact lens case. I don't know. It was weird. Using that for months, but my eyes kept getting so, so, so dry. So if you're having that problem, it's not because of your contacts, because that's what I thought they were. It is from your solution. It kept drying my eyes out. And like within a couple hours, I've just, like, my eyes just felt so dry and they'd get really red. By the end of the night, like, I feel like I just could not wear my contacts as long. And I felt like usually a general pair of contact lenses can last a month perfectly fine. But with these ones, I felt like the time on them was like decreasing dramatically because of how dry they were. So I feel like that was gonna affect the long-term life of the actual lens. Anyway, I went to another place and they gave me a little sample of the Opti-Free Pure Moist. Now there's three different Opti-Free solutions. One's Replenish, one's like an Express, and the Pure Moist. I think this one is new. And I tried the Opti-Free, both the other two, I believe, ones, did not like them, and I was just like, oh, I didn't even notice that this was different at first. But then just, I noticed that some days I was like, my eyes, they're not dry anymore. I wonder what that could be. And I realized when I was just looking at the bottle one day that it said Pure Moist, and I'm like, that's new. So did a little research, found out it was a different one. So this little baby has saved my contact lenses big time. So yes, the Pure Moist, it's very moisturizing. You wear your lenses all day and they still feel moisturized by the end of the night. Obviously your eyes get tired, they will turn red generally, usually they do, for me at least. But yeah, this, like, that still happens, but they still feel moisturized with this. So I need to pick me up a bigger one, or like 5. Yeah, that's really good. And last but not least, it is a food item that I have been eating all winter long. I think my body is just having enough of chocolate, but chocolate. This is the Ghirardelli. I have no idea how to pronounce it. Chocolate squares in the dark chocolate with sea salt caramel filling. Let me tell you something. These are incredible. It's like, you know, caramel, the chocolate. That, but that chocolate does not taste good. This tastes good. And the sea salt, I feel like it just uplifts absolutely everything. Like the flavors in your mouth, it like brings some sort of like zing to them or something that just, I don't know, lifts the flavors. Just incredible. So that's pretty much it. There are obviously other flavors in that chocolate if you don't like dark chocolate. As I've mentioned in previous videos, dark chocolate is like my new thing. I love it. It's so good, so tasty, and it's healthy. So add a little bit of sweetness to that. If dark chocolate's a little too bitter for you, with this one, like the caramel, it makes it a little bit sweeter, but I love caramel. I like caramel. I'm not a caramel fan, but this one is top notch. Love it. Anyway, so that's pretty much it. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and I do apologize on not posting anything anytime soon, but, or sooner, but I mean, what can you do? It's life, and life gets you and puts you through so many different twisters and tornadoes and hurricanes and flips you up upside down and all around, and you're back pretty much where you started. But sometimes they work out. You just gotta flow with life. That was like the worst. Yeah. Do let me know what your favorite winter, favorite beauty, miscellaneous, etc., etc. items are. If you obviously made a video on them, link in the comment section below. And I will probably get around to watching them. Because, I mean, us YouTubers, we gotta stick together. We're like one big, awesome community. So yeah, do like this video. Comment if you have any comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe. I said like already, but that's okay. And yeah, hopefully I'll see you in my next video. Hope you have a super wonderful and fantabulous day. Bye!